The Codex Gigas is the largest extant medieval manuscript in the world, more famously called the Devil's Bible due to a full-page illustration of the devil himself and the legends that swirl around the book. It takes two people to lift the book, which is made of more than 160 animal skins. It was written in the 12th century AD, and it currently resides in the National Library in Stockholm, Sweden. It is thought to have been created in the Benedictine Monastery of Podlasis in Bohemia, modern Czech Republic. It contains the Vulgate Bible as well as many historical documents, all written in Latin. During the Thirty Years' War in 1648, Codex Gigas was written by a monk who made a deal with the devil after being sentenced to death by being walled in alive. With the devil's aid, the monk wrote the book in a single night. The portrait was painted by the devil himself, which composed of 310 leaves of vellum allegedly made from the skins of 160 donkeys or perhaps calf skin. It initially contained 320 sheets. Oddly enough, the handwriting in the book is remarkably even and stable throughout, as if it really was written within a short period of time. However, it would take at least an estimated 5 years of non-stop labor to write the work, and most scholars believe it took about 30 years. Some of the sheets were subsequently removed. It is unknown who removed the pages or for what purpose, but it seems likely that they contained the monastic rules of the Benedictines. At first glance, the contents of this bizarre book are equally strange. It contains a full Latin Vulgate Bible, interspaced with several other books, including Antiquities of the Jews by Flavius Josephus, a collection of medical works by Hippocrates and Theophilus, from 1649 to 2007. The manuscript was kept in the Swedish Royal Library in Stockholm. The site of its creation is marked by a maquette in the town museum of Krast. On Friday, May 7, 1697, a fierce fire broke out at the Royal Castle in Stockholm, and the Royal Library suffered very badly. The Codex was rescued from the flames by being thrown out of the window. The Codex apparently injured a bystander and some of its leaves fluttered away, and they are still missing today in September 2007, after 359 years. The Codex Gigas returned to Prague on loan from Sweden until January 2008, and was on display at the Czech National Library. Today, it seems bizarre to us why a manuscript would have such disparate texts, but it's important to understand that a monk would often confine himself to a desk as a form of penance, spending his lifetime copying important or interesting works. Multiple work manuscripts were common due to materials being rare, making it an imperative to use all available space. The discipline and craftsmanship of such an undertaking is a skill that rarely exists these days. A National Geographic documentary included interviews with manuscript experts who pointed towards evidence that indicates the manuscript was indeed the work of just one scribe. The manuscript includes illuminations in red, blue, yellow, green, and gold. Capital letters are elaborately illuminated, frequently across the entire page. The codex has a unified look as the nature of the writing is unchanged throughout, showing no signs of age, disease, or mood on the part of the scribe. This may have led to the belief that the whole book was written in a very short time, but scientists are starting to believe and research the theory that it took over 20 years to complete. Thank you.